What's up, guys? Welcome back for the next episode of Weird West. We're back doing stuff and things. Do you have a skinning tool bag on you? You do not. That's fine, I suppose. Either way, let's go. We've got a bounty we can collect on, or we could start doing the story. I think we should start doing the story, though. So let's go do the story. Okay, we could look for answers at Elephant Spine that's related to the person we're looking for, or we could look for the taproot. Let's go to Elephant Spine first. I'm more curious about, you know, my past and all that stuff, why I got turned into a pigman, and all that junk. Got a new mercenary with a gold rifle, so that'll help out a decent amount. Oh, hello.
Little body's starting to rot.
Deer.
Smells something awful. Maybe whoever won the brawl left some tracks behind.
Maybe. Ah, little girl. A massacre. They're lucky they got to leave this spirit's forsaken place. Well, now, look at you, passenger. If I could still joke, I'd make some pun about you wallowing. I'm curious, can you laugh, being in another body? Can you feel? Feelings are for the weak! And yet I can hear it in your voice, the texture, disgust, fear. Welcome back, Seeker. It's not fair that you're the one who gets to experience feeling. After all, you've put us through. Let's not draw this out any longer than we have to. Your pigman, he's looking for his past, isn't he? Well, get to searching, answers are here. How long have you been alive, girl? Ironic, you of all people asking me that. Let's say I remember the old home language, and the language that came before that. Let's say I've seen enough empires rise and fall that they feel regular as seasons. All this so-called life, it's no more than snatches of bad weather. Sky's empty behind it, a vast nothing. That's where I live. Are you following me? I'm not supposed to. That's what she said, or that's what we said. But I'm fascinated. It makes me almost feel something to see you fighting out here. Can't stay away. Okay. Well, creepy. All that spilled fruit punch. Exactly. And is this copper cleaver? Take it, I guess. Of course. Orders. Bring brothel owner alive. I want him to squeal. I get it. You know the way to Canker. Okay, apparently we're going to Canker. Take that. Alright, well. There you go, I guess. Trail to Canker. Anything we need to dig up or anything here? Doesn't look like it. Alright. It's not too far away, actually. Enemies in the bush. Oh, it's you. You just put your vendetta out for me. Shell got messed up. See you later, Axel. You tried. At least my teammates don't care that I'm eating corpses. You'd think that they would. I'm sure some people don't like it. The mercenaries are just like, eh, whatever. You paid 200 bucks for me. Let's do this. Should have had the spaghetti western song going in that shootout. Yeah, right. Can't remember what that's called. Is that song called The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly? I can't remember. Bird nests. Something I learned. Check bird nests. I think we're at 2 cards now. Any more bird's nests? Nah. Okay. I haven't been in an outright duel yet. I think eventually I will. Apparently the two who escaped can speak. Soul transfer didn't work. Wanderer magic must be. Doesn't make sense, they're not wanderers. Or are we? Whatever the reason, their trouble, we must find them and kill them. Ooh, they're gonna kill me, guys. Lots of pigs here. Think so. Turn that off for a reason. Nope. Keep it off. Dang it. Oh, are you gonna try and go turn this on? Yeah, I didn't think so. Lights back on. Dang it. It's funny that they're trying so hard to turn these lights back on, though. That's everybody. There you go. Guess these bodies don't want to burn. There you go. Maybe it's because they're. Maybe it's because it's raining. I don't know. Sweet. I don't have any food. Know where I can get some food, though. I know. Should I really... Oh, there they go. Took them forever. Shame? What do you mean, shame? I'm freaking doing what I got to out here. Not for the faint of heart, little mama. Oh, heck. Random ass card. I'll take that. That was a very randomly placed. Yeah, that's Lil Mama. She changed her Twitch name. Back to Lil Mama. So how many cards do I have now? I've got three. What do I want to do? I can increase my max HP. Move faster. Reduce shop prices again. More money. 50% chance to save one of your lockpicks. Let's do health. So it's not additive. See? She's cleaning up the fruit punch. Sweet. Bandages are always a welcome thing to see. Jane, I'm gonna give you one of these bandages. Michelle, you can also have one of these bandages. We can go ahead and continue on with what we're doing. We're probably not going to get away from this unseen, so. Knives, not a lot of guns, which I suppose is good for us. So the bleeders have guns. Also, that's a lot of red dots in that center room. What kind of enemies are over there anyway? Are they asleep? Yeah, I think they're asleep. Okay, that's questionable. Okay, we gotta be a little careful here. Do not want people to be alerted. That light switch, huh? That's what you get! Stop turning lights on. Okay. Let us continue searching. Coming in here. Yes, you are. You gonna go turn that light on? Interesting. Do what I say, not what I do. Nailed it. Okay. Little Bob, but they just have a sense like, I feel like there's one room that's dark now. I must fix it. Exactly. Musty note. Soulless voice is self-control, is free will, remove this, and power through another mind is held. Ooh. Spooky. They are pretty obsessed with pig people here, huh? Astral Gate? That's interesting. Let's not do anything with that right now. Ruth, I had such high hopes for you, but your obsession with bodily transfiguration, it's not the Wanderer's way. We see the future to avoid danger. We don't bend the present to our will for our own purposes. You leave us no choice but to expel you from the temple. May our paths not across again. Edith Frond. Edith Frond. Okay. Pig ear, flasks, stuff. Anything else? Chemicals? There's a notebook I need to pick up. Clarence Quigley's journal. Oh, this is where I was held. Day one, a setup. Ambushed me at Elephant Spine. Cecilia wasn't even there. Brought me to this place for what? Day two, heard squealing. Like a pig, but human too. Got a bad feeling. Day three, heard Ruth talking about taproots. Bet she's got Cecilia locked away at one of them. Day four, they're taking me to the workshop. Floods, if somebody finds this, please go get Cecilia. Ruth must have her at one of those taproot places. As for me, just ask around for the dapper-looking snout. Okay. Ooh, telepathic message. You're at Canker, I can sense it. Idiot. Bacon meat? Doesn't matter if you burn the roots there, you won't burn the others. I'll make sure of it. Ruth bow. Ruth, stop doing telepathic things. I don't like it. Hey. Brandon Brown. Floods, you talk? You ain't gonna experiment on me none? Boy, that's a relief. Others ain't so lucky. There was another fellow in one of these cells. Brothel owner, I think he was. Screaming about some lady named Cecilia while they were chopping him up. Well, best antidote to fear is a couple of shooting irons, I always say. Maybe we could team up, get some revenge on the folks who did this to you. What do you say, take me along? It's full, bro. Suit yourself, but I ain't sticking around. Alright. It's okay. Just glad that I could help you. Okay. This place has things in it. They're all asleep. So many repeat books. Yeah, they're all asleep in here. Now we burn them all. I'm sure there's a better way to deal with all of them at once. What the fuck? I was kind of thinking about bringing chemical barrels in here, maybe, or bringing a bunch of explosive barrels. Maybe explode them somewhat all at once. Try to do that anyway. It'd be kind of tough, though. You gonna go try to turn that light off? Or turn that light back on? Not on my watch! The other bodies. Yeah, she sensed it. They're so strange. There's a person. We're gonna take the long way around and get behind him. Licks one finger, holds it up in the air. Yes, there's a light off. Yep. It's just like wind directionality, but with light. That person also did the finger lick. Checking for stuff. No. Stop talking to me. Wanted to close the door, but one by one, they all woke up with a gut feeling of darkness in the back room. Exactly. I might be able to knock them out while they're asleep. Can't remember if I can do that or not. I know I could steal from them. Can knock them out. So one thing they're going to be adding via an update is the ability so that NPCs can't notice or don't notice bodies of people that are asleep if you knock them out. This guy's going to see all those people knocked out in bed. Like, what? Why are you asleep in bed? Turn around. What? The hell happened there? That was weird. Gotcha, sucker. It's almost everyone. Why are you asleep in bed? Do you not care? There's a light off somewhere? Exactly. I don't think so. Is that everybody? Like, did we get everybody? I think we got everyone. I didn't search all those people in beds, though, I don't think. See, they see all those stars coming off them, and then they're like, those are stars, not Z's! Everybody get up! one thing that I recommended to the devs add to the game is if a character finds someone unconscious, they should have the ability to wake them up. Like if you're on higher difficulties or something. Because it's a little ridiculous that enemies just leave their friends knocked out on the ground, you know? I think that would be a good addition. Spice it up a little bit. It would kind of add more weight to your actions as far as, you know, killing people and not killing people. I mean, right now, I don't see there's any reason to not kill everybody. But, yeah. There is somebody still left. And there's a taproot. Ah, shit. Close. Close to getting everybody. Well, it's not that big a deal. So that's a taproot. Okay. Good to know, I suppose. Nothing here. Nothing here. I guess I gotta burn it. I do have Molotov cocktails I could use for this. Or I could see if I could just, like, throw a candle or a lantern or something at it. Gotta find one first. There's a candle. Fire! Fire! God damn it. Candle always lights me on fire whenever I don't want it to.
Fire licks at ancient walls. Sultry's taproot glows bright, then turns to cinder.
It's back. Alright, well. Guess that taproot's done. Last taproot location. Got the last taproot. Place called Horsetail Grotto. Heard it's filled with Ruth's people, so bring ammo. Thank you, Pigman Joe. Alright. Zan's fire bad. More like Zan's is bad with fire. Am I right, folks? Do, 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 do. Hey, Salmonella came here just in time to watch me, you know, drown all these people. Great timing. Great timing. I'm not a psycho. It's okay. They deserve it. They're bad guys. The drowning is a little awkward sometimes. Biscay's psycho confirmed. Nah. Nah. A real psycho would poison them and drown them. Got him. Ow. Oh, didn't get him. Didn't get it on time. Nah, whatever. All right, let's go. Let's get out of here. Enough being psychotic. And that is how the Zanzibar Man became the origami killer in Heavy Rain, drowning kids for fun. Oh shit, that is how that worked, huh? I remember playing that game. Phrasing! It is me, the Zanz. What's up? That was a fun game. Heavy Rain, I played that a few times. Didn't get all the endings, but fun game. Wait, is this Heavy Rain? No, doll. It's not. This is Weird West. Pretty fun M-Sim. Right. If you're watching on the stream, stick around. I'm going to keep playing. But if you're new to the channel, I like to make cuts for my YouTube. So that's what this is right now. So do not adjust your televisions. I'm not going anywhere. But as far as YouTube is concerned, that is going to do it. Thank you for watching. Follow, like, subscribe, so on and so forth. You guys know the deal from now. I'm going to drink some soda. And then we can start back up for the next episode.